All right, so here I did go ahead and research some info for your property. I'm just gonna move this screen over so I can show you what I found. So what I usually do first of all is I type in the property to the NARRPR. That stands for the National Realtor Property Resource Site. And as you can see, usually they have a valuation, but this is a very specific type of property that there's not enough comparable results of properties that are as like your property. So they did not put a valuation here. So it is a little bit more difficult to evaluate the property, but what I did is I went through on MLS and I did my own valuation process. And I did different square radiuses to find like properties that are not actually on the water because that's going to drastically affect value. So what I did is I found properties that have expired within the last year. And then what I did is I found all the sold properties. So as you can see here, these six properties have sold. And I went ahead and did a took all these six properties and I find the average square foot, the average price per square foot that is sold. So when I pull up that other sheet, where did it go here? This is what I came up with. So the list price, the average price, this is the price it could sell for on the lower end. This is saying the price it could sell for mid-range, and that's the top price that it could sell for based on other properties that have sold in your area based on the square feet. This is what has actually sold within the last year, that's close to your property. And then these are the days on the market that you can expect. So what I would say is my recommendation is I would come through and make some suggestions. We would do some staging, some virtual staging. They can do that. And in the other video that I sent you, if you watch that, you can see the virtually staged samples, which looks phenomenal. The price isn't really the issue. It should be able to sell at what it was previously listed at, but just to be safe, I would probably recommend going somewhere around this price point, maybe slightly lower, and then hoping that we get multiple offers, or we don't have to. We could go somewhere closer to what you had previously. Where was that? I apologize. So it did expire at 589.9. So I probably still would go a little lower than that. And then if we do those things that we're doing and market it correctly, you should have no problem selling it. Feel free to let me know if you have any questions. Please go ahead and watch that first video that I sent you that shows how we got those 16 offers within 2 days of showings, as well as how we're getting, I believe we got up to about $178,000 above the average sale price, going in a specific neighborhood, but that was on one of the properties that we pretty much did to the tens. We renovated and redid everything, and did our maximum marketing for that property. So I'm very confident that we can get you a really good price that you're happy with. And if you're not happy, you don't have to move forward. You are not required to accept an offer with us, but we hope that you do, and we're gonna try our best to get you that top offer so that you do choose to move forward. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. We'll talk to you soon.